Hi, and welcome to The Lab. I'm USBC Director of Coaching, Stephen Padilla. I just want to talk to you a little bit today about some physical game pieces. We're going to start with specifically the stance and something that everybody has going into their approach. I want to get specific on it and talk about a couple of key points, but these are just general ideas we talk about when we're really thinking about what to look at and how to address somebody getting started. The stance is the beginning of the approach. It's where somebody's going to really set up and kind of get their body in position to start their athletic movement. One of the biggest key factors we see in the game is the posture of the player getting into that stance. And most of the time, you want to see the posture slightly forward. So we'll see them just a little bit over their hips or over their footwork with their upper body. The posture is going to be a big key point to making sure that you're athletic and ready to move forward and accelerate through the shot. One of the other areas that's going to be key in the setup is going to be where the feet, knees, and the hips are all pointing, where they're moving out when they get ready to start moving. So the feet, the knees, the hips are all going to be pointed pretty much the same direction for the most part. And most of the time we see people that have a liability of turning their feet or hips in different directions, they're not going to be able to repeat shots as well as those that keep all those pieces going the same way. Another key component to the stance is going to be what the shoulder alignment looks like, especially in our sport. Bowling has to do with alignment, with targeting, repeatability, accuracy, a lot of features that really get the player to do the same thing time after time from shot to shot. And the shoulder alignment is key to making sure that the ball direction is going to go wherever the player wants it to go. So for the shoulders, we want them to go the same direction that maybe the feet or the knees go, but we're also going to have the bowling or the ball side shoulder, it's going to be slightly lower than the non-ball side shoulder. So for example, you're a right-handed player, your right shoulder is going to be a little lower than your left in your setup. Now that's because you have weight in that side of the body. So when you've got more weight on that side, you tend to lean that direction, as well as start to move the lower body out of the way by positioning that shoulder slightly lower than the opposite shoulder. Another thing in our game specifically is going to be the ball position, where you're going to place that relative to the rest of the body's positioning. And left to right, we tend to see most players take the ball position and go somewhere between their chin and their ball side shoulder. Now they're not going to sit directly under most often, and they're not going to sit directly on the shoulder, but they're going to place it somewhere in the middle of those two, or some comfortable position that sits off that ball side, so that when they get started in the approach, most of the time you're going to have your body move around the ball, and that ball is going to be in place so that it balances right by your side as you're getting started. Now, left to right is one direction, but we got to consider up and down as well. A lot of times the ball position in the stance is going to be right there around waist height or slightly above the waistline. That's going to give us a good balance, and it brings the weight or the mass close to the core of our body. When we bring it close to our core, that keeps the weight of the ball feeling much lighter in our stance. So we don't have a lot of weight away from us, we don't have it out to our side excessively, but for the most part, the closer we keep it to our body to start, the lighter it feels. It makes it easier to start into the approach. We also want to consider the hand position. What direction is the hand directly related to the shape of the bowling ball as we get into our stance? And most of the time our players find that the bowling ball sits on top of the hand, or the hand sits directly underneath, not to the side, perhaps not on top of it, but more times than not in the stance, players are going to have the palm of the hand sitting directly underneath the ball as it sits high to low and left to right in that position. That also corresponds directly to what the elbow position is going to do. So the hand position is going to sit under the ball, the elbow position is going to sit directly behind that in line with the target path. So in our stance, again, our hand position's under, our elbow's in line, and with those two pieces, we simply want to place that in the same direction that we had those other pieces, our posture, our feet, our knees, our shoulders, all those pieces going that direction. Same thing with the hand and the elbow. Those are going to go the same direction toward that target path. So we've got a lot of the ball side set up already in place. We're in our stance. Consider now not just what the bowling side's going to do, but look at the opposite arm or the opposite side. It has a specific placement as well. Most of the time, for the players that we see successful, and we're talking any level, we're looking for balance between the ball side and the opposite arm. So instead of having the opposite arm rest on top of the ball or sit in front of it, perhaps sit on the side of it, most of the time we see it underneath the ball as well to help support balance. And that balance 50-50, if you can get it, is ideal for what we see most players in their stance getting into, so that when they get the ball into the start position, now they have a very balanced feed from the opposite arm into the bowling arm. So the opposite arm's placement when you get into the stance is very important. Now, there's exceptions obviously to the opposite arm. One of the exceptions would be in a two-handed player's approach. A lot of our two-handed players don't start with opposite arm under the ball. They'll start with it actually out in front or maybe slightly on top of. And that positioning of having both those hands close together, is what sets up the preset or the beginning stance of the two-handed approach most often. Now they won't hold it usually as high as the shoulders, they'll keep it closer to the waist level or perhaps somewhere around the center of the core. But most of the time with the opposite hand on the two-handed approach, they're going to start with a hand out in front of the ball. That's going to compensate for them getting into the downswing or into the backswing. It helps as the opposite arm comes back, kind of acts like the thumb if they're using their thumb in the approach or in the ball. So the opposite arm has a lot of a function when it really comes to direction and support of the bowling hand whenever you get into the stance. As a whole, you want to take all these pieces we're talking about and consider which preset angle you're getting into. So the preset angle to me is one of the important factors when we really start dialing in exactly what direction we want the ball to go. We get onto the approach in our stance, we get all of our things lined up, and then we want them all lined up the same direction toward our target path. So whatever you choose to target with, whether it's the arrows, whether it's the dots, could be the range finders or the pins down lane, along that entire process of what we're talking about for the physical game, we want to make sure all those pieces are lined up the same direction. So preset your angles, make sure all your pieces are in line, and it'll be much easier for you to take your stance and be successful from shot after shot.